Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the channel. This is the first video in a series where I talk about Jack and Daxter for the month of December to celebrate the Precursor Legacy's 20th birthday. And every time I say that, it just puts into perspective how old I am and how long this series has been in my life for. But god damn it, I'm gonna celebrate this series this month and you're gonna enjoy it. You're gonna enjoy the ride with me. But anyways, I feel bad because I knew that Jack and Daxter, the Precursor Legacy, was approaching its 20th birthday this year, and I had something planned for like the last couple of months, but it didn't end up happening. Like, I was planning on making this big video on the Precursor Legacy, like this love letter to the game that started it all, the game that started my love for this friggin' video game series, and it didn't come to fruition. I don't have a capture card. Like, all the footage that you're seeing right now and for the month of December is stuff that I clipped on my PS4 and then uploaded it to YouTube and then downloaded from YouTube onto my computer, which is why it doesn't look so great. If I had a capture card, it would have looked better, but I ended up not getting a capture card. I also don't have any good video editing software. I'll be completely honest with you. Right now, I'm using OBS to record this. And then afterwards, I'm gonna go into the Windows 10 freaking video editor and throw in some background music. Like, that's how my video editing process works. It's pretty basic, but it's not to the level that I want it to be. And it kind of sucks because I'm kind of doing this video game series a disservice by doing that. But god damn it, I'm gonna be talking about it for the month of December. That's my compromise. Instead of making a giant video about Jack and Daxter, the Precursor Legacy, I'm just going to be talking about the entire series for the month of December to celebrate. And this could be a thing for, you know, for years to come. Every December is like Jack and Daxter month, and I just talk about Jack and Daxter for the month of December on this channel. That sounds like a good idea. I don't know. We'll see. But anyways, when it comes to the Precursor Legacy, I actually do have some fond memories of this game. It's not my favorite one in the trilogy. It's my third favorite. Jack 2 is my favorite, followed by Jack 3. And Jack 2 is my favorite game of all time. But the Precursor Legacy, I do have some fond memories with it. Like, I remember the first time I got this game. And it's a very vivid memory because I remember one stupid detail of it. So one day, this was around 2002, like late summer, early fall, my parents went to the mall to buy something, and when they came back that night, it was about 7 o'clock. When they came back that night, they were carrying two things that I remember very vividly. One of them was Jack and Daxter, the Precursor Legacy, of course, and the other one was a bucket of KFC. I don't know why I remember the bucket of KFC so well. I didn't even eat the chicken that night. I just popped in Jack and Daxter right away when I saw that they were carrying it, but That was a really stupid detail that I remember, but I want to mention it. But I remember seeing this case, Jack and Daxter. I didn't even ask for this game, right? At the time, I only had two PlayStation 2 games and one PS1 game. I had Gran Turismo 3 A-Spec, NBA Live 2002, and then the PS1 game, I think I still have it here. Oh yeah, 2 Extreme. Which was fun, like, at the time. It was really fun. So I didn't really have any other games after that. Like, I didn't ask for anything. I'd usually either guilt trip my parents into getting me a new game, or I just get some games when it was my birthday or Christmas. So when they came back with the Precursor Legacy, I was kind of surprised. And I looked at the case. First of all, it was that ugly-ass red logo Greatest Hits case. It wasn't the black label, it was the red label. And I saw the Naughty Dog logo on the game case. And I was familiar with the Naughty Dog game because before that, I had a PlayStation 1 before it got stolen. And I was playing Crash Bandicoot 3. Crash Bandicoot 3, or Crash Bandicoot Warp, was the game that introduced me to video games. It was my favorite video game at the time. And I remember it was developed by Naughty Dog. And I played that game religiously. So I was like, ooh, it's a Naughty Dog game. I'm familiar with Naughty Dog games. Let's pop this in and see what it's all about. And it was a completely different experience than what Crash Warped was, obviously. It's a new generation of video games. The level design was different, where Crash Bandicoot had more of a hallway design. Jak and Daxter's levels were more open. You can attack it however you wanted. And right after the first cutscene, right when I jumped into Geyser Rock, the tutorial level of the game, I was instantly hooked. Like, I had so much fun with this game within the opening minutes. It looked beautiful. It still looks great. I feel like this series has aged well, in my opinion. Jak controls really well. I love the characters. I had a little bit of a crush on Kira, I'm not gonna lie. I was 8 years old. What do you expect? But it was such a blast to play through. And I always turned to this game whenever I had nothing to do, or even when I had more games as the years went on. I always turned to this game because it was so accessible. It wasn't overly difficult, but at the same time, it wasn't super easy, right? And it was like a basic collectathon platformer. One, I already love platformers, and two, I like collecting things because I'm that type of a person. And it was just easy to play. Like, I could just pick it up, play, and just go about my day. I don't have to worry about anything. I don't have to worry about any specific objectives. I don't have to worry about, doing any specific missions. I can just go about the levels, collect the precursor orbs, collect the scout flies, collect the power cells, and just go through the game super casually. And that's what I really appreciated about this game. That it, one, it wasn't overly difficult or easy. And two, I can just pop in the disc and just go about my day, just go about the levels and have such a good time no matter what. Even now, 28 years old, I played this game recently, finished it in one day, and I still had a lot of fun with it because it looked beautiful and it was just fun to control and it was fun to get stuff. And honestly, I wish that Naughty Dog would, focus on this series again. I know they won't, but I just want this series to come back into the gaming scene in some sort of way. Look, man, the Video Game Awards are coming up this week. Maybe something's gonna happen. I don't know. But I just want some sort of Jak and Daxter announcement or something for the new generation because these games are honestly really solid. Like, sure, the tonal shift between this one and the sequels is a little bit shocking, but goddamn, these games are still fun. And I have so many memories, like so much fond memories of this game. So many memories? Does that make sense? Is that the right English? I don't know. But oh, also, about a couple months after that, like 2003, like August, I believe, there was this massive power outage. And not only did it affect the, like, Ontario, I live in Ontario, I live in Canada, but it affected some of the states as well, from what I remember. And before that happened, I was playing Jak and Daxter. I think I was in Lost Precursor City. And the power went out. And I was nervous. I was also pissed because I didn't get to save my progress. And Lost Precursor City, in my opinion, is one of the most annoying levels in the game. But I didn't save my progress, so I had to start that level all over again. But I was nervous because whenever I turned off my PlayStation, I would always take the disc out first and then turn it off. When the power went out, the disc was still inside, and I thought my game would get damaged because of this stupid power outage. And this power outage lasted a couple of days. Like, I remember going to I think it was the pharmacy or something, getting some candles, having to eat craft dinner, using the lighter to ignite the stove. Like, it was a rough couple of days. And the entire time, I was super nervous that Jak and Daxter, the Precursor Legacy, was gonna get damaged because of this stupid power outage. But when the power came back on, it didn't happen. The game was still fine, and it still works today. But man, this series has been a part of my life. Like, it changed my life. It sounds fucking cheesy to say that, but this series honestly changed my, it shaped my childhood and shaped my early teen years. And compared to the other video game series that I really enjoy, like my other favorite video game series are Yakuza and Persona. Like, if you compare this series to those games, the story isn't that in-depth, and like the themes and everything are completely like they're more fleshed out in Persona and Yakuza compared to Jak and Daxter. But there's something about this game that I will always come back to. And it's not just a nostalgia thing. Like, these games are genuinely a good time. They play great still. I mean, the sequels are a little bit shocking with the whole open world concept. I'm gonna be talking about that in another video when I talk about Jak 2. But like, if you have a PlayStation 2 still and you haven't played these games yet, I honestly highly recommend them because they're such a good time. And they're really accessible. They're not hard, they're not too easy, like I said earlier. But you'll have a good time playing these games, I feel. And again, I just wish there was more Jak and Daxter representation in the gaming community nowadays. Like, goddamn, if Ratchet and Clank can still get games developed even to this day, even on the newest generation of consoles, dude, there's still a chance for Jak and Daxter. Like, there was a Jak and Daxter Easter egg in the latest Ratchet and Clank game where you can see Jak and Daxter when you shoot the rhino, I think. Like, goddamn, Insomniac. Get the rights to the title. Naughty Dog's not gonna do anything anymore. Like, God damn it. Naughty Dog only acknowledged this title on social media, and they didn't even like post that much on the Precursor Legacy's 20th birthday. There were like three or four different posts on their Instagram. I don't know what they did on their Twitter because I don't have Twitter anymore. But dude, come on. Insomniac, I'm waiting. I'm waiting for you guys to get the rights to this title because I think you guys can do a good job with Jak and Daxter. But anyways, before I get off onto that little rant, I just want to mention the memories I had with the Precursor Legacy. Like I said, it's not my favorite game in the trilogy, but I always come back to this game whenever I have nothing to do or whenever, like, fuck, whenever I'm even feeling down, I'll play this game because it just puts a smile on my face. Not just nostalgia, but it's just genuinely a good game. But anyways, that's all the time I have for today. I don't want to ramble on for too long. We're already pushing like 13 minutes, so I'll just leave it at that. There'll be more sort of retrospectives on the sequels as well, more videos like this, especially for Jak 2, because Jak 2 is my favorite one in the series. So there's gonna be a lot more story times or memory lane revisitings, whatever the fuck you want to call this, for the sequels. And this is gonna just, honestly, doing videos like this just puts a freaking smile on my face, man. I love this series so much, and expect a lot more content for the month of December. But anyways, that's it for today. I'm gonna leave it at that. If you like this video, feel free to like it. If you dislike it, that's okay. Feel free to dislike it. I'm totally okay with that. Ladies and gentlemen, I am CD Panda, and I will see you next time.